turn the radio.
Sports Radio, Sports Radio.
This music brings healing, brings joy and life to the depressed. Oh, gotta keep on. Mighty conqueror, destined for success. Oh, I'm a winner, and that's it. Oh, I'm a winner, and that's it.
I've got a winner in the studio this evening, a man by the name of Mr. Brian Lawrence, in the name of Jesus. 22 minutes on the other side of the hour of 6 o'clock. Brother Brian, good evening to you, man.
Good afternoon, Dablo. Thank you for that marvelous introduction. Glory to God.
Amen. Hallelujah, man. Glory to the name of Jesus, right?
Amen. His mercy and goodness endureth forever and everlasting.
Indeed, indeed, man. It's a pleasure having you here.
Thank you.
You know, sometimes, you know, we get in this walk with the Lord, and then, you know, there are times when we kind of almost want to question, are we there yet? Is everything okay? Are we still standing on solid ground? And what do you do when those times come with you?
Well, Dablo, from the Lord have blessed me with the Holy Spirit, Dablo. I tell you, my life has been turned around. A renewal of my spirit, a renewal of my soul, a renewal of my health. Dablo, I had a stroke last year, April, Dablo. I had a heart attack, a stroke, a high blood pressure, everything in one. They had to rush me to the emergency room. That was Sunday morning. Monday morning, my hand paralyzed. I couldn't talk. I couldn't walk. Half my body couldn't move. They came for me to write, to sign my name on the petition for the hospital to register you, admit you. Dablo, I'm right-handed. It was on my right side. I couldn't even lift my hand up. I couldn't even hold a pen, much less the right. I had to use my left hand. I had to make an X. And that was Monday morning, Dablo, and a gentleman came and said to me, he said, sir, you're one of the luckiest fella I've ever seen who come to this hospital. He said, you had the triple threat and you're still alive. He said, it has to be a reason. You know what he said to me? He said, you got a second lease on life, quote unquote, a second lease on life. And Dablo, I remember that, man. And that man said to me, sir, go home and put your face to the wall and pray to your God, Dablo. Dablo, that was Monday morning, Dablo. Half my body still paralyzed, Dablo. To make a long story short, by 7 o'clock that afternoon, they was admitting me out of that hospital. They released me. Glory to God, hallelujah. This mercy endures forever. Dablo, they released me by 7 p.m. Monday afternoon in a good bill of health, Dablo. I don't know how the transformation came about. The only thing I could say is it's glory to God. And in that time, I'm a sinner. I am. Hallelujah. Goodness and mercy in your
truth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory
hallelujah,
to God. Hallelujah. Jesus in the miracle business.
That's who I am. More than a conqueror.
So 25 minutes past the 6. Much more coming back. Hold on. The man Brian Lawrence in the studio.
I've experienced challenges and dispatched obstacles from my way. How you respond will tell the outcome of your day. Oh yeah, yeah. Attitude.
attitude determines altitude. To reach God's promise, I'm on my way. I won't bow nor roll over. This is my testimony. Say I'm an overcomer, and I'm standing tall. Ostracized and criticized, friends and families even despised. I've been bound and trodden down, lost my smile and even gained a frown. Depressed and distressed, heavy laden, even felt emptiness. But by the power of the Most High, delivered by His righteousness.
The man called Rondell Positive this evening. Well, the man definitely taking place of the man Rondell Positive. The man is known as Brian Lawrence. So Brian Lawrence, we're going back to you again, and you and your encounter with Jesus Christ. So you were not saved. You were not saved.
No,
and but you believe in God.
Well, yeah, I believed in God from a little child in Trinidad. I know about the Holy Trinity. As a little boy growing up in Trinidad, going to the Catholic Church, they always speak about the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and the power of the Holy Trinity. Uh-huh. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So I know of that. And then at the age of 12, they sent me to St. Vincent. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Because see, when I land in St. Vincent, I land in a home that it was occupied by the Holy Spirit. There were souls in that home who were saved. But as a child, I never knew that. I didn't know that. But now I can look back and reflect and yeah, because my aunt, she still is saved up to this day. Glory mm-hmm. to God. Bless her soul. And I grew up in that home from 12 years old until I was 17. And my auntie, every Sunday, I had to go to church, regardless of what. Have to be in church. I'm a bad boy. I have to be in church. Have to be in church. Regardless. So I had to, every Sunday I'm in church. Yeah, I used to leave church and go and play ball. Yeah, they send me to Sunday school. I used to go to Sunday school. I go and play ball. Did they give me tights? The drawing tights. I take in tights and go and buy Morbi and cake. Yeah, that's what I'm doing with God money. Now I can look back and say that's what I was doing with God money.
I didn't know better.
As a little boy.
Amen.
Because the church was right across from the Savannah, where big team playing ball in the morning. So I used to sneak out of church and run and play ball. So I grew up in that home, and I knew about God, and I came to America at the age of 17. Knew about God. I found Rastafari at the age of 18. Pray to God. Praise God. Read my Bible. Try to live a righteous life as possible. But no matter what I do, nothing was fulfilling. Nothing was manifesting. There was no glory. Always a struggle. I worked in two jobs. Getting $700 every week. And bam, bam, I broke, man. Ross, that go on for 35 years, man, until in Brookdale Hospital. So, I leave the hospital Monday night, walk out of the hospital, Ross, come home. Week hit my bed. Ross, I lay down in bed for about 90 days, just bed rest. Just bed rest and water, bed rest and water, bed rest and water. Kill plenty water, Ross, bed rest and water, until I revive it. I remember what a man tell me, Ross. He says, "Star, go and put your face to the wall and pray to your God." And Ross, I did that evening. I put my face to the wall. And I said, "God, I tried everything in life. I tried Selassie. I tried Rastafari. Ain't nothing manifest. But hear what? I never tried Jesus Christ. Never tried Jesus Christ. I'm willing to accept Jesus Christ. Why? Pressure in me behind. Broke. I live with my mother, ain't walking. Pressure. You know, when pressure take it, bus pipe, uh-huh. You jump and you repent. So I pour out everything, but I ain't had no choice. So I pour out my stomach, I pour out all my supplication. Humble myself and I just pour it out, Raz, pour it out. I say, Jesus, God, I'm willing to try Jesus. I'm willing to try Jesus, Raz. Raz and I, man, feel tired, I went and sleep, Raz. Raz, and when I wake up, glory to God, hallelujah. Raz, I wake up with a joy, a peace, a comfort, a happiness. I want to know what's going on. Just a overwhelm of joy, happiness.
But what prompted you though? What I mean, you said you were going through some hard time.
Yeah.
But what led you to Jesus? What led you to that?
Raz, what led me to Jesus when that man tell me in the hospital, Raz? Go over and put your face to the wall and find your God.
Raz,
I'm sick, Raz. Raz almost died, Raz. I'm saying, I knew I was going to die, saying way before this show happened, I told my mom, I said, Mom, I feel right now, I think I'm going to die. But during that time, I said to her, Mommy, I'm in this world, but I'm not of this world. Glory to God, hallelujah. I tell you the truth. Mommy, I'm in this world. I say that a lot. Mommy, I'm in this world, but I'm not of this world. Not knowing what I mean, but that is the flow. I said, say it constantly. I'm in this world, but I'm not of this world, Mommy. And Rah, Saint, the glory of God came over me. And from ever since, and not only healed me, because I stopped taking my medicine from August. You know, I say, wait, I started to go to church. That's what do it to her, boy. See, church? Yeah, boy. Church is important, boy. Church give you a teaching. Church give you a teaching about the ways and the things of God. God have his rules. God have his ways. God have his laws. God have his commandment. And as saints of God, we have to obey them and abide by them. Each and every day, morning, noon, and night. Like Paul said, pray without ceasing. So we have to abide and obey God. Once you obey God, your life will be cool. In other words, we're not be obedient.
You notice a big difference with you being in the with the brethren,
yeah,
and in the fellowship.
Going to church.
That kind of really ignite the fire.
Going to church and having a good pastor who can give you the doctrine that you could understand and relate it and go home and put it into practice.
Amen.
What paths are further than that?
So you remember the helping hands?
What do you mean, man? Helping hands.
Amen.
Here was set the talk. Book of Malachi. I didn't know about paying tithes on them thing. And the book of Malachi say, bring ye all the tithes into my storehouse, and I will open up a treasure house and pour it onto you. There won't be room in your storehouse to hold it. I read that. I say, paying tithes, I waited, but I started paying my tithes and go to church and do the things, right? And glory to God.
So right now you're grounded, right now you're finding yourself.
Yeah, man, I know myself, no brother.
You know that Jesus is Lord.
Lord, kings of kings, lords of lords, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah.
Period.
Elect of God. The earth
says so nobody else.
Rightful ruler. No one else. But Jesus Emmanuel Christ.
The name that is above every name.
Every name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Goodness
and mercy endured.
Indeed. Overcomer in the building this evening.
Every time.
Overcomer. 35 minutes after 6 o'clock. Put you chatting with a man that came from way down and
way
came
down.
Right up to the top.
That's
with victory in Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
Yeah,
man. So firm I stand. Experience challenges and dispatched obstacles from my way. How you respond will tell the outcome of your day. Oh yeah, yeah. Attitude determines altitude. To reach God's promise, I'm on my way. I won't bow nor roll over. My testimony. Say I'm an overcomer, and I'm standing.
criticized, friends and families even despised. I've been bound and trodden down, lost my smile and even gained a frown. Depressed and distressed, heavy laden, even felt emptiness.
Woo!
But by the power of the Most High, delivered by His righteousness, I'm an overcomer.
I'm standing strong.
Indeed, indeed, the man is in the studio, man. My brother, let me tell you something. The joy of the Lord is my strength. Sometimes, I mean, I don't know how to say it, but, you know, I mean, it's just awesome to be in the will of the Lord. It's awesome to be serving the Lord, my brother. It's awesome, and every day is a newness. Every day is a new awakening with God, you know what I mean? And that freedom, you feel that freedom, that liberty.
Unbelievable.
Tell me about it.
Unbelievable, brother. Amazing grace. That's what it is. Amazing grace, man. God is marvelous. God is wonderful. God is worthy to be praised continually, eternally. Praise ye the Most High for His goodness and mercy in your death. God has blessed me in so many ways. I have to glorify Him. God has lifted me up from the ashes and restored me to kingship. Glory to God. Hallelujah. His goodness and mercy endure forever. Praise thee the name of the Lord. Dablo is worthy to be praised.
He is worthy, my brother. He is worthy. He's no joke about it. He's worthy.
And when he comforts you and bless you and uplift you, you have to give him his glory. You have to glorify his
Nobody
name.
Nobody can love you like Jesus.
No.
Nobody can love you like Jesus.
Hey, let me tell you, I was a Rasta man one time, and I used to fight for loving man. Now I could say, what? You see that man there? I'm in love with that man. I have a fiance, and I just tell my fiance, it's nothing above my God. I'm in love with my God first. I put my God before each and every thing. My God run 1, 2, and 3. First, second, and third. First, second, and third. Yeah.
So somebody listening to radio audio right now, what would you tell them? I mean, what would you say to somebody who going through, or somebody who have not found Christ yet?
What would
you encourage them, or what would you tell them to do, or what, you know, how can they submit themselves? How can they find Christ? It as from your perspective,
brethren and sister, glory to God. Brethren, go in your closet. Find your. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. So, brethren and sisters, you gotta find your secret place. You have to find your secret place, because God want your undivided attention. God want your undivided service. So when you pray to God, look for the quietest place where no one will disturb you, no song, no music, and bow your head, bend your knees. Put your head between your legs and pour it all out, people. Pour it all out. Tell him how much you care for him. Tell him how much you want him. Tell him how much you need him. Pour it all out. All your supplication. Ask him. He said, ask and shall be given unto you. Let your request be made known unto God.
Indeed.
People, it's simple. 1, 2, 3. Simple. You know, when you find a girlfriend and you love a girlfriend, or you find a boyfriend and you love a girlfriend. Boyfriend, I just go and you pour out your heart to them. Simpler.
You said making a dedication.
What do you mean, man? That's all it is, bro. Simple. Just pour it out. Find a secret place and pour it out, man. And you take it from there. Once he know you sincere in your heart.
Sincere in your
he
heart.
He will take it from there. But you have to make the first step. He won't come to you. Because he created you. So why should he come to you? We have to fall forward to him, bow to him. Accept him for who he is. The Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the bright and morning star. Amen. Jesus, you know, Christ.
I was reading this text there from Luke 5. You know, with the casting out in the deep.
I heard it. Yes. Yeah. While I was, glory to God. You know, I went in the shower and I take my radio with me, Raz, because I don't want to miss nothing, Raz. That's how I feel about church radio.
Hallelujah.
I don't want to miss glory nothing, to especially when Dablo on the radio.
Well, we give thanks in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
you know,
my brother.
We're just
my
keeping
brother.
It real as we can
glory
be.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Yeah, you know, the reading here is, you know, going out and you know, casting your net in the deep, you know, because many people fishing, but because if you check the text, what it says, he said, it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake Gennesaret and saw two ships standing at the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. But then, now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught. And Simon answering said unto him, Master, we toil all night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, very key word, nevertheless,
amen.
At thy word, I will let down the net. And when they had done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net broke. And they beckoned unto their partners, which were in another ship, that they would come and help them. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's amazing. So just casting into the deep.
Yeah.
It don't make no difference how much time you've been doing it, but where you've been doing it. Where were you fishing before? And many people have been in the body of Christ for years, and they don't have the experience that we're talking about. But the thing about it, God is saying that the experience is there. Everything the word of God tells you is there. But you just have to find it.
Well, I think they have the experience. Because once in the body of Christ, the Holy Spirit will give the leading into all truths and rights. So I think they have the experience, but they refuse to lean onto their own understanding, so to speak.
No, I mean, I know about that. Because if you experience, you cannot experience the Lord and be the same way. You cannot experience the manifestation of the Holy Spirit in certain ways and still not take it serious, if you understand what I'm saying.
All right. The scripture said there's apostles, there's pastors, there's preachers who will know the word of God, but who will know the word of God, who understand the word of God, who preach the word of God, but still they will deviate from the word of God. So that's what I'm trying to say. A man of God, it's possible for him to deviate for whatever circumstances cause him to deviate. I don't know. But there's strong man in God who will deviate from the world.
Why do they deviate? What do you think is going on?
That's for them. I
you don't know. But for you,
I focus on me.
For you right now,
I focus on me. I try to keep. You know, when
so for you now, you can't get away. You won't get away from it.
I try to stay in the word, brother. I have to day and night meditate on it day and night. You have to pray day and night. Even when you're working, you have to Jesus. By his stripes I'm healed.
You have to maintain a flow.
You have to keep encouraging yourself.
Indeed.
Yes, you have to stay in it constantly.
Amen.
All this is
fishing in the deep.
Amen, brother.
You know,
amen.
All this is fishing in the deep, because you can't just
glory
be saved and you're not going into the word of God.
Yes.
Because that's the same thing I'm trying to show you.
Yeah.
What the text is trying to say.
Yeah.
Yes, they're doing it. But what they're doing, they're not doing it deep. They're not sincere. They're not going deep enough. They're not committed to it.
Right. Once in a body of Christ, that's when you're at the dead. You're at the deep. Because deeper diggers, more water,
now
the well
you
find it.
Amen.
They had a dig.
Amen, the man.
Yeah.
Lawrence in the building this evening. Talking about the goodness of God and talking about how far God has taken him from. And
amen.
Right now he's standing on a solid rock.
Devil in a trouble now.
The devil in a trouble now, right?
Devil in a trouble. Smack him wrong. Boom, bam, boom. We tear down them chamber hall. We mash up all them conference room.
I said the devil in a trouble now. Now that I know. You've given me power. You've given me authority. Jesus. Say when the enemy comes at me like a flood, and thought I'd lose hope, throw in the towel and give up, your spirit reminded me of my first love, the power you gave me through your blood. You clothed me with righteousness and made me victorious. A heart of thanksgiving, I must declare you are glorious. Bless me with the power to tread upon scorpions. I'm already a winner by your nail-pierced hands. I'm more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror. That's who I am. More than a conqueror, I'm more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror. That's who I am. I'm more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror. That's who I am. I'm more than a conqueror. More than a conqueror, I'm more than a conqueror. Sometimes feeling troubled and don't know what to do. Problems piling up, everything coming at you. But encourage yourself as your spirit is renewed. Cry out, Abba Father, and see you through. Hey, don't look left nor right. Don't you lose focus. God's about to deliver and the promises made us. Ears of a king and those giant tears with Jesus. If God is for us, you tell me who is against us. More than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, that's me. I send the devil in a trouble now. Now that I know. You've given me power, you've given me authority, Jesus. Oh Lord, oh Lord. Say when the enemy comes at me like a flood, and thought I'd lose hope, throw in the towel and give up, your spirit reminded me of my first love, the power you gave me through your blood. You clothed me with righteousness and made me victorious. A heart of thanksgiving, I must declare you are glorious. Bless me with the power to tread upon scorpions. I'm already a winner by your nail-pierced hands. I'm more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, conqueror,
more than a conqueror, that's who I am. More than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, that's who I am. I'm more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror, that's who I am. I'm more than a conqueror, more than a conqueror.
Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. If you just joined us, the man Brian Lawrence in the studio. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus, my brother, indeed. And you know, the thing about what I notice as a believer in Christ, you really have to claim the things that the Bible tells you.
Yes.
and believe it to yourself. You know what I mean?
Very much.
That's
so.
The way it really works. So. You know, you could say that you know that you're saved, but you have to claim it.
Brother.
You got to claim it to yourself. You have to talk to you. Yes, you have to
believe it.
Mm-hmm.
You got to believe it. And once you believe it, you put it into effect. And once you put it into effect and believe it, it will manifest. It will manifest. Brother, I should feel some pain coming. Feel some pain coming. And I say, by his stripes, I'm healed. By his stripes, I'm healed. By his stripes, I'm healed. I'm cured from all sickness and disease. Yeah, my brother. And the pain will stop. The pain will go away. The pain will stop. It will go
Amen.
Away.
Amen. God is real, my brother.
Stop and it will go away.
God is real.
Yes,
as
I
real.
Am. Yes, I am.
I remember one night I left the studio, one evening, and I was at a real, the day was very, I mean, the power of the Holy Spirit was so strong. I went home, I was like drained. I was like drained. I mean, you know, I was on a high, but I was drained. I needed to just like, you know, just wow. You know, it was a Saturday evening, and I went home, man, and there was somebody, just two people was cussing and carrying on, and some Spanish people carrying on and making some noise downstairs and stuff like carrying on and stuff like that. And my brother, I just say in the name of Jesus, shut up.
Yes,
I
want to
sleep. Just yeah. in the name of Jesus.
Jesus, you
brother, it's like a switch turned off. Like on and off. I ain't talking about low volume.
Low volume. Cut right away immediately.
From high up. Yeah.
Just stop.
To just
cease.
Cease. If you drop a pin,
you hear it. Here. Yes.
I said, man, God is just awesome.
Awesome. It's great. Marvelous. Wonderful. Man. Immaculate.
In the name of Jesus, you just say it and it just happened just that so way.
Yes, I claim it and
once
believe
you have
it in
faith
your heart.
And you believe it. My goodness. Work, hallelujah, my brother. Yes.
Work.
So encourage somebody out there who listening to the radio now. Because some people, they know they might like just the music. But they're not really convinced about this God business. They like the music, but they're still not committed. They don't want to go to church and give their life. They don't want to, you know, commit. They have all kind of different things in their head. But they like the music and whatever, but they're not taking God serious. Well, what would you tell them?
Radio Land, you have to practice what you preach. Practice. Put it into practice. Start little things. You will grow. Start. It's like a baby. You start drinking milk. Then you move on to mash up food. And then you move on to meat. So you have to start baby step, and then the baby step will turn into footstep, and then the footstep will turn into strides, and the strides will turn into the bigger running. So you have to start somewhere. Start with the basic, always the basic. Because if you start from the top and you don't know the basic, you will have to always come back to the basics. So you have to start with the basics and elevate. Don't worry how long it will take. Time is nothing. God will work with time. So time is not of the essence. Time is not of the essence. Your whole life is dedicated to God anyway.
Amen. But let me ask you one question though. As you say, you was a Rasta man. Mm. Kinda, you know, and being a Rasta man and now being in Jesus. Mm. What is the feeling now? Because back, what is the feeling? It's like what is the acknowledgement that you have in the two areas?
Two
yes, being a Rastaman for us and praying to Selassie and whatever. What did you feel in your spirit, and what do you feel now?
Rastaman was trials and tribulation, struggling each and every day to survive, pay your rent, keep roof over your head, pay your bills, keep a dollar in your pocket. Maintain yourself. It was a struggle, constant struggle. A battle every day. In the body of Christ, it's royalty, kingship, richness. All that I can ask for. I just have to believe in it, manifest it, and it happened. It's unbelievable. I'm new in the body of Christ, and the things that I seek glorifying me and manifesting in my life in a short space of time. I'm scared to say some of the things over the air, bro. I'm telling you, brother. Trust him, because I want people to think I'm boasting.
Listen, but there must be a boast in the Lord.
It's all about glorifying God.
Of course. Hallelujah.
People,
yes.
Last year, April, this time, I didn't even have a dollar. I used to try to play lotto to get a little money, man. Play lottery just to get money. Taking my little $5 that I don't have to give to them people and nothing happening. And now, through the glory of God, man, I have 4 bank accounts.
Glory to God.
Ask me how I don't know. Glory to God. Pinch myself.
Pinch yourself and see if
ask me, man. God. From I used to live with a lady and she passed away in 2001, man, and I ain't been with no one since then, man. Just being faithful and truth, and God come and bless me with a wife. God send me a fiance. People, if I could have picked that girl myself, I couldn't do a better job.
Hallelujah.
Tell you the truth, man.
Glory to Jesus.
If I was to go there and say find that myself, I would have never seen like that. And the Lord bless me with a daughter of Zion, man.
Oh my goodness.
Glory and honor, man.
So you're ready for the next move
ready
right
for
now.
The next move.
Glory
ready
to
for
the next
name
move.
And, to tell
you. And you know, my brother, this is one of the key elements about, you know, believers and that separate believers from believers. You believe in God, and, you know, people reading the word of God for years. and they continue to violate the God. They read the word, they see what it says, they know, and they continue to violate God. And you just come in recently, and well, just like me too, you know, we say, man, we got to do what's right unto the Lord. We got to do what is right. We can't just say we believe and we don't want to honor the word of God. It's important.
Hear what people, man. You had to forget the worldly things, man. That's what I, hey, you had to leave that world behind because that world was no good to me. So now anybody in Christ, I ain't wanna see them first. That's why I despise them so because it was no good to me.
Good to you,
yeah. So now anybody in Christ, I could pick them up. Fire.
Fantastic.
If my people will not worship and praise me, they'll rise up sticks and stones. But I won't allow that, Lord. Sticks nor stones. Won't ever get to offer my praises. Sticks nor stones.
Glory to God, man. Goodness and mercy endures forever. Glory to God, man. Glory to God. His goodness and mercy endures forever. Praise ye the name of the Lord God forever. His goodness and mercy endures forever.
Then I'll rise up sticks and stones. But I won't allow that, Lord. Sticks nor stones. Won't ever get to offer my praises. Sticks nor stones.
He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy.
Hallelujah.
Glory to the name of Jesus.
Amen, brother. Amen. Praise to all the saints in Radio Land. All the saints in Radio Land.
Amen.
We send our praises and glory and honor to all of you. Maintain and praise the Lord. Praise the Lord all these days of your life.
Amen.
And the goodness and the fullness of the Lord will bless you and maintain you and your family. Praise ye the name of the Lord. Saints of the Most High God. Amen.
In Jesus' name. I know you got to go pick up your fiancé.
Yes, time is running out. Yes.
Thank you for sharing the little moments with us and in your own way, just, you know, giving us a little acknowledging God in, you know, in what you, you know,
He's worthy to be praised,
W. And He's worthy, my brother. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised. And my God.
While I'm on the air,
hallelujah.
I want to take some time out to thank a lot of your oracles who come to the studio, W. There's some ladies like Sister J. Sister J, I listen to you every morning in the morning, Sister J. Your special service, your encouragement words that you give to us in the morning. There's a sister that comes on at 5 and 6, Sister Khan from the Ark of Christ. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We love you and we adore you. We commend your works, all of you, the works you do at Choice Radio. People listen to you. The world listen to you. Continue the great works and the Lord will bless you and keep you. Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Well, I know how to talk about you, W. I tell you all the time. I don't tell you.
You just give God honor.
Yeah, man.
Brother, yeah. We definitely appreciate the appreciation. You know,
amen,
it's all about,
brother.
Not about us.
No, it's all about God, the works of God.
And, you know, that's
God.
Really what it's about.
He will glorify us, but we have to give Him the glory.
We
when He glorifies us,
glory.
We have to give Him all the glory. Because the glory is due to Him.
Yes, indeed. And that's one thing I don't want to get caught up with all this, you know, excitement and, you know, forget about God in the mix. You know, that's why, you know, we just want to just keep it, you know, to the Lord and give Him His glory and give Him His praise and let it just be about Him, you know what I mean?
It's always about Him and
the
one is. He and His Son.
He's worthy.
It's all about Him, His Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah. So, my brother, safe journey. Let me thank you for coming by and glory
thank
to the
you.
Name of Jesus. We're going to be talking some more as things progress and things, you know, transpire.
Thank you.
But so far, I just wanted you to pass and just share your little experience and, from where you was and where you are now with the Lord and you're standing on a solid rock and you know that God is and, you know, it's glory to the name of Jesus, man. You know what I mean?
And I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to thank you, God, for accepting me, for grafting me into the family of the saints.
Amen.
I thank you with all my heart.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Right now,
amen.
While His presence is here, let's be still in it. Just gaze at His presence. Forget who's around you. Forget who's looking at you. Just thank God for His presence. You are so holy, Jesus.
I'll be still in Your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's Your name that I lift, Lord, oh God. I'll I'll be still in your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's your name that I lift, Lord. Oh God, your name is holy, Lord. Your name is holy, God. Your name is.
Give him praise this evening. He's worthy.
Lord.
Glory to the name of Jesus, man. He is worthy. I cannot say it enough. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be lifted high. He's worthy to be exalted. Don't care what you're going through. It doesn't make a difference. It doesn't make a difference. Especially if you decided to walk away from this world. Walk away. Completely walk away. Don't look back. Don't hinder yourself. Let's go all the way with the Lord. Let's go all the way, brethren.
God, his presence is.
He's waiting to overflow you. He's waiting to do all that he promised to do in his word. He's waiting for you to do your part. Do your part.
God,
glory to the name of Jesus this evening.
Right now, while his presence is here, let's be still in it. Just gaze at his presence. Forget who's around you. Forget who's looking at you. Just thank God for his presence. You are so holy, Jesus. I'll be still in your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's your name that I lift, Lord. Oh God. I'll be still in your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's your name that I lift, Lord. Oh God, your name is holy, Lord. Your name is holy, God. Your name is holy, Lord. Your name is holy, God. Somebody sing, I'll be still in your presence. And I'll be stranded forever, Jesus. It's your name that will lift high, God. Oh God, I'll be still in your presence. I'll be stranded forever. It's your name that I live, Lord. Oh God, your name, your name is holy, Lord. Somebody tell him, your
I'll be
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Woo! To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power.
Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on, you declare it.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
There is power
in the name.
In the name of Jesus.
We know where it is. To break
and break every chain.
Break every chain.
Break every chain.
Come on, say it to me.
Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
There's an army rising up. There's an army rising. There's an army rising up, yeah. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Say there's an army.
There's an army.
If you're part of the new army, go ahead.
Morning, I hear the chains falling.
Don't forget the Christian family tonight.
Hear it.
At 8 p.m.
I hear the chains falling.
And we're dealing with marriage.
In the spirit, I hear the
very powerful program.
The chains falling. It's loud.
We're going to bring part 3 and part 4 this evening. Talking about marriage and the family. Glory to the name of Jesus this evening. Brother Dave, good evening to you. Brother Lewin.
Lord, I don't know where to begin. It's this flesh, the flesh I am in. I try to walk away so many times, but it seems I'm bound by this
I'm desperate for. Wanna see your face.
Choice Radio everywhere. Log in to www.choicegospelnetwork.com or listen on your phone by dialing 213-493-0146. You can also download the TuneIn Radio app on your cell phone and look for the Choice Radio and enjoy the sounds of praises.
I've seen men hang themselves on trees. They never stop to smell the roses, feel the soothing breeze. This is the kind of news we hear every day. But I wonder if they found time to pray. How can you love somebody, yet take the person's life? How can you truly love, yet live in strife? You say you love your husband,
Love your children, love your wife. Get your slave them with poison, gun or knife. How can you be so heartless? How can you be so cold? Not realizing that you need to be made whole. Well, I don't mean to hurt anyone, nor make you more sad. But my sister, my brother, true love comes from God. On trees, they never stop to smell the roses, feel the soothing breeze. This is the kind of news we hear every day. But I wonder if they found time to pray. How can you love somebody, yet take the person's life? How can he truly love, yet live in strife? You say you love your husband, love your children, love your wife. Yet you slay them with poison, gun or knife. How can you be so heartless? How can you be so cold? Not realizing that you need to be made whole. Well, I don't mean to hurt anyone, nor make you more sad. But my sister, my brother, true love comes from God. My sister, my brother, true love comes from God. We need to kneel daily at the altar and weep. We need to cry out to God for His saving grace. We need to purpose in our hearts to seek His face. The best prayer doesn't seem to move our souls. The best sermon doesn't seem to warm our hearts that are cold. The best song is seen as just another rendition. We need to labor in asking God to heal the hearts of all men. We need to labor in asking God to heal the hearts of all men. How can we be so heartless? How can we be so cold? Not realizing that we need to be made whole. Nor make you love comes from God. My sister, my brother, true love comes from God.
Choice Radio everywhere. Log in to www.choicegospelnetwork.com or listen on your phone by dialing 213-493-0146. You can also download the TuneIn Radio app on your cell phone and look for the Choice Radio and enjoy the sounds of praises.
I've seen men hang themselves on trees. They never stop to smell the roses.
Choice Radio, here we go, here we go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Want inspiration? Want to be lifted and refreshed? Turn your radio.
Choice Radio, Choice Radio.
This music brings healing, brings joy and life to the deepest. Oh, gotta keep on listening.
Choice Radio.
Mr. Mark. So it all comes down to love. Stephanie, come and join me on this one, wherever you are. Oh.
Radio has established a prayer line Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. The number is 718-715-4411. Please call for help, for prayer, and for counseling. If there's no one on the line, please leave a message. They'll get right back to you and offer prayer with you. Please call Choice Radio 718-715-4411. Choice Radio Network.
We're gonna teach you this song. Come on, sing, sing it.
I said, oh, 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 it all comes down to love. Oh, 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 oh.
That's the only word. Let's sing it again.
I said, oh, 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 it all comes.
Michael, you can come join me on stage too. Listen. Said talking heads talking to us on the television. Silver screen preachers, politicians say they got the answers. First they want to squeeze us. Send a little money, what a tax on Jesus. Fix it with a prayer, fix it with a dollar. Anybody out there ever want to holler?
Oh, 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 oh. It all comes down to that.
I can't hear you.
It all comes down to love.
Second verse says, self-help guru got a bestseller. Talk show host got a drag queen bank teller. 1-900, look into the crystal. The NRA says you better buy a pistol. Made a little pill, but it might cause cancer. Just a cheap bill, when looking for the answer. Now tell them the answer.
Oh, 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 oh. It all comes down to love. Oh, 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 oh.
Wall Street, they make another million. Theater on the back street, talking to your children. You cry for help, nobody listens. You lay awake at night, wondering what's missing. Who can put an end to all the confusion? Open up your heart to the only solution. Oh, 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 oh. Remember it all comes down to love. Oh, 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 say it again, say it again, say oh, 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 oh. It all comes down, down to love. Oh, last verse, when I was Africa, I said, sing it up in Joburg, tell it in Soweto. Sing it in the gold mine and in the ghetto, the blood of Hector Peterson crying for apartheid. Tell it in Washington, the dream will not die. Bishop Desmond Tutu, Nelson Mandela, Martin Luther King, they only want to tell you. They only want to tell you. Oh, 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 oh. Said it all comes down, down to love, yes it does. Don't ever forget it. Oh, we got to love one another. God bless you. Thank you.
Twenty-one minutes on the other side of the 7 o'clock. Till the evening. It all comes down to love. Hope you're in a good mood this evening. Remember, life is what you make it. Indeed. Brother Sylvester, good evening to you, brother. The entire family. Good evening to your beautiful wife. Yes, indeed.
Fountain flowing forth. clean. Oh, be washed in the blood of the Lamb. Say, are you washed in the blood? In the soul, cleansing blood of the Lamb, the Lamb, the Lamb, the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood?
Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Choice Radio.
God is watching me. Sitting at home thinking back to all the things that you've been through. Worrying how you're gonna make it, you don't.
know it's gonna work out now. Sitting down there just wasting time in the dark, or you don't have a dime, not even to pay your lights. Regretting how you lost sight, sitting down there thinking back to all the things that you've been through, worrying how you're gonna make it. You cry, sitting down there just wasting time in the dark, cause you don't have a dime, not even to pay your light. Regretting how you lost sight.
You can't run, you can't hide, you tried it all, you backslide. You can't run, you can't hide, you said no, you try to fight. You can't run, you can't hide, you tried it all, you backslide. You can't run, you can't hide, you made a pact, and so it's do or die.
God is watching, watching you. God is watching, watching. God is watching, watching you. God is watching, and you're running, and you're running, and you're running, and you're running away. And you're running so far that you don't know which way to take. And you're running, and you're running, and you're running, and you're running away. And you're running so far that you don't know which way to take. Remember,
you can't run, you can't hide, you tried it all, you backslide. You can't run, you can't hide, you said no, you try to fight. You can't run, you can't hide, you tried it all, yes, you backslide. You can't run, you can't hide, you made a pact, so it's do or die.
God is watching, watching. God is watching, watching. God is watching.
Hey, reaching out to Pastor Ferdinand with this one. I know you love that one indeed. 40 minutes on the other side of 7, it is Choice Radio. Your life, your salvation, your choice. We are here to encourage you, lift you up, let you know that God is worthy. He's worthy to be a child of God. He's worthy to praise Him. He's worthy to just be saved. It's worthy, man. It's good. We just want to encourage your soul this evening, all right? In the name of Jesus. Keep that smile on your face. You've made the best decision in your life to walk with the Lord, all right? Keep casting your net out in the deep. All right? Yeah, man.
I'm trading my sorrows. I'm trading my shame. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. Sickness, I'm trading my pain. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. We say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. But not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for His promise will endure, that His joy is gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, His joy comes with the morning. So I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness. I'm trading my pain. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. You say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. We say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. I am pressed but not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned,
struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for his promise will endure, that his joy's gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, his joy comes with the
Choice Radio everywhere. Log in to www.choicegospelnetwork.com or listen on your phone by dialing 213-493-0146. You can also download the TuneIn Radio app on your cell phone and look for the Choice Radio and enjoy the sounds of praises.
That complete trade over.
For the joy of the Lord.
Oh man, I want to take it one more time from the TOP baby. Whoa! Thank you, Jesus. What a vibration this evening. What a vibration. Can you feel it? Hallelujah. Choice Radio.
I'm trading my
Miss Valencia, good night.
I'm laying
Sister Jake, good night to you, baby.
Joy of the Lord.
And all the fans who love the Lord, we continue to encourage you. Stay with the Lord Jesus. He's worthy to be praised.
I'm trading.
Yeah. Don't care what it feels like.
I'm laying.
You've made the best decision in life.
For the joy of the Lord.
Oakley family, good evening. Louis family greeting.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes.
The Gabriel family, all the crew, man.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
All the folks online and on the phone lines greeting to you.
Lord, yes, Lord.
All the folks on the websites, Lord. Fresh back indeed. In the name of Jesus, we just greet you in the matchless name, man. The Lord is good, he's worthy, I'm telling you, man. Some powerful testimony today, I'm telling you, man. You out there, man. God is awesome, baby. Take him at his word. Take him serious. He's holy. He's mighty. He's high. I would encourage you, man. Whatever the Bible tells you that you can achieve and you can do, you can accomplish, go ahead. Strive to do what the Lord asks you to do. Trust him that he's going to make it well. He's going to fix it. Whatever it is. He will never go back on his word. I'm telling you. Do it right unto the Lord. I'm telling you, man. Hallelujah. Cast out into the deep. Yeah. You're fishing too near the shore. Cast out in the deep. Christian family at top of the hour. We're still into the marriage. The third and fourth part this evening. Say yes to him this evening. Say yes. Oh, man. Getting you ready for the Christian family. It's a Thursday, beautiful Thursday evening. Sister Alicia, I hope you're up and running by now. I want to thank each everyone this evening, all the young people, good evening to you. Glory to the name of Jesus. We thank your family for making you listen to Choice Radio. Trying to train you up right with some powerful things to add to your life. Will empower you.
I'm treating my sickness.
Miss God, a good evening to you.
I'm treating my pain. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. Do we say yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. I am pressed but not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for his promise will endure, that his joy is gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, his joy comes with the morning. Joy of the Lord.
Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. We say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen. I am pressed but not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for His promise will endure, that His joy is gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, His joy comes with the morning.
Somebody tonight gonna definitely trade it over completely. Give them for the keys too. Come on, why you want the key for it? Go ahead, give over the whole car with the key, the title, everything. Come on. Why you keep holding on? Come on, give it away. Let Jesus come in and take control. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Sister Mac, good evening to you, baby. Fleming Cool. How you guys doing?
I'm trading my shame.
Menendez family, good evening. Hamilton family.
Laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness. I'm trading my pain. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. I am pressed but not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for His promise will endure, that His joy is gonna be my strength.
And if you heard the man, Brother Brian Lawrence, tonight. The man is new in Christianity, new, just born. And the man has seen so much victory in the name of Jesus because of sincerity. Coming in with your whole heart. Committing to the things and the way of God. That's what God is saying.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord.
As we climb to the top of the hour, I got a song that just drive me. I mean, that song just reminds me of my salvation and getting free in Jesus. I'm gonna play it for you right now. Shake yourself. You're free from the devil's rot. Hey! Woo! If you're free in Jesus, my God, Christian family, top of the hour. Let's do this. Listen. Woo!
Without a warning, you changed my heart. Your power, Jesus, tore it apart. When you found me satisfied in my sin and pride, well, you came to let me know this old man must die. Well, it started with a whisper, but it became a shout. When it started with a whisper, when you called me out, when you shined your light, shining in on me, that Holy Spirit light got a hold on me. I found peace and joy. You know I found freedom. I said I found
right after this one.
For me.
We take you to the Christian family. I. Something to write with, something to write on.
Yeah.
We're inside marriage tonight.
Got a hold on.
Part 3 and part 4.
When you rip the bell.
It's been my pleasure being at your leisure.
Through.
With all the musical treasure.
Free.
Yes, indeed.
Free.
Glory to the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Take him serious. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy of all our praise. Hallelujah. We love you in the name of Jesus. Get you back here tomorrow at 5 o'clock in the evening time if the Lord tarries. All right, guys, we love you in the name of Jesus. Everything we say is with love. And we are all going to experience Jesus with all that is perfect and promised in the book. The great book that is alive and cutting. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. Good night, guys. Good night. Good night. I love you.
Without a warning, you changed my heart. Your power, Jesus, tore it apart. When you found me satisfied in my sin and pride, well, you came to let me know this old man must die. When it started with a whisper, but it became a shout. When it started with a whisper, when you called me out. When you shine your light, shine it in on me. Let it in, let it in, let it in. Well, you know I found peace and joy. You know I found freedom. I said I found love when I found Jesus. But I didn't go looking. No, he came for me. Well, I didn't go looking. No, he came for me. Well, he shined his light, shining it on me. That Holy Spirit light got a hold on me. When he ripped the veil and the truth walked through, he set me free. When he set me free, I let him in, let him in.
We're looking at a month-long series entitled The Christian Family. We're looking at many things for the father and the mother, husband, the wife. Now we're taking a look at the children, seeing on this scheme of things what God has to say about those children. They are what tomorrow. Is that true? Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 1. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and thy mother. Verse 4. And you fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Now this is some information he's given us here. First, notice he tells the children to obey their parents in the Lord. This is right. And you're going to have long life if you obey your parents in the Lord. Then he went on to verse 4 and talked about the fathers. Fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Educate them in the things of the Lord. Nurture, that word nurture means to give them what is good, like nutriment. Give them spiritual nutriment. And to admonish them in the Lord is to give them a mild rebuke, to put them on the right track, things of God. When they get off track, put them back on track. So you're telling the fathers, notice that's the fathers, you fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Give them good things when they get off the course. You can rebuke them in the name of the Lord, bring them back on course. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Children, obey your parents, the Lord, this is right. Honor thy father and thy mother, that may be well with thee. is a commandment with promise, and the Ten Commandments to the fathers. Now we want to go back where we left off in Deuteronomy chapter 11 and see something. Deuteronomy chapter 11. Now notice these things you have to do. You don't do them, they're not going to be done. Deuteronomy chapter 11. We look at one scripture in Proverbs chapter 22, and I think it's verse 6. Train the child the way he should go when he's old and not depart from it. The way he should go. Remember that?
Yeah.
And look at here in Deuteronomy 11. And verse 18. Deuteronomy 11 and verse 18. Therefore shall you lay up these my words in your heart and in your soul, bind them for a sign upon thy hands, that it may be a frontlet between thy eyes. You know what's a frontlet? A frontlet is a band, like a headband. Put that band on and you put scripture in that band. So wherever you go, you're seeing this scripture. God is good, greater is he who is in me than who is the world, as a frontlet. Look at verse 19. And you shall teach them your children, speaking to them when thou sittest in thy house, when thou walkest by the way, when thou liest down, when thou rising up. And thou shalt write them upon the doorposts of thine house and upon thy gates. Notice everywhere you have it in you. You put it on the door, you put it everywhere. When you're lying down and you're rising up everywhere. Notice this is what you have to do for your children. Verse 21. That your days may be multiplied, the days of your children in the land which the Lord thy God sware unto your fathers to give thee, as the days of heaven upon earth. Now notice, if you do this, your life going to be prolonged and your children's life going to be prolonged. So if you want long life, it's something you have to go about it. So long life is not up to God, but it's up to you. You notice that? No, he said, with long life will I satisfy. Well, what is long life? Long life is a relative term. Long for some people is short for others. He said, the days of your years are going to be 70 reason of strength, 80 years. That's 80 years on the low side. He told Moses that he can live to be 120 years. Can you see that? Well, Moses was not saved, and they say he lived to be 120 years and his natural forces abated not. So he telling you, if you want long life, look at what you do. Let's read these verses again and see what you do with your children. So your children can determine long or short life with you. Look at this, look at 18. Therefore shall you lay up these my words in your heart and in your soul. Bind them for a sign upon thy hand, that they may be a frontlet between thy eyes. So this is a band that you carry in your hand with the scriptures, or a headband you carry around with scriptures in it. Carry it around with you wherever you go. Verse 19. And you shall teach them your children, speaking of them when you sittest in thy house, when thou walkest by the way, when thou liest down, when thou rising up. And thou shalt write them upon the doorposts of thine house and upon thy gates. So everywhere turn to scripture. You have it upon you, you have it in the door, you have it in the gate. Everywhere there's scriptures. Can you see that?
Yes.
Amen. Verse 21, that your days may be multiplied and the days of your children. Can you see that?
Yes.
So by you teaching your children the scriptures, by you having all these scriptures in for them, you can multiply your days and multiply their days.
Amen.
Can you see that? How important it is you with your children? God is holding you responsible for the children. So when these children arrive in heaven much before, too early before their time, God is holding you responsible.
Yes.
Because he tells you, train the child the way he should go when he's old and not depart. So if you don't train him, he's not going to be trained. Children isn't born trained. They have to be trained. Remember we looked at a scripture yesterday, saying foolishness is bound up in the heart of a child, but a rod going to get it out. Remember that?
Amen.
Good. So he come with that in him, and you have to straighten that out. So he's telling you, if you want to get long life, you train your children. I think we ought to read that again. I like that. This is nice.
Yes.
We need to read that again. Somebody's just tuning in, and they need to listen to this.
Yes.
You need to listen to this. You have short life or long life because of your children. Look at it. Look at verse 18. Therefore shall you lay up these my words in your heart and your soul, and bind them for a signs upon thy hand, that it may be a frontlet between thine eyes. Every day you look, you're seeing these scriptures before you all the time. You remember, this is a picture, because remember the old covenant, the types and shadows of the new covenant. When Peter was walking on the water, he was looking at Jesus.
Yes.
And as he keep looking at Jesus, he walk on water. The minute he take his eyes off Jesus, he begin to sink.
Yes.
So he said, keep these scriptures before you all the time.
Uh-huh.
keep it before you. Look at it. Look at verse 18. Therefore shall you lay up these my words in thy heart and thy soul, and bind them for a sign upon thy hand, that it may be frontlet between thine eyes. When between thine eyes, thou shalt teach them your children, speaking of them when thou sittest in thy house, when thou walkest by the way, when thou liest down, when thou risest up. It seems like all the time. It's when you sit down, when you lie down, as you walk, wherever you are, you're talking about the scriptures all the time. Faith come by and hearing what? The word of God. Verse 20. And thou shalt write them upon the doorposts of thine house and upon thy gates. Look at verse 21. That your days may be multiplied, and the days of your children in the land which the Lord thy God sware unto thy fathers to give to them, as the days of heaven upon the earth. So you can have heaven and earth by what you do with your children. Can you see that? Your days could be like hell and earth with your children also. You don't train them, they drag you in. Can you see that? Glory to God. Look at Deuteronomy 21. Deuteronomy 21. You don't train them, they just don't train themselves. Train the child the way he should go. Train him the way he should go. That's a commandment. That's not a suggestion. You don't train him, he's not going to be trained. Children just isn't born trained. Have to be trained. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy 21, and look at verse 18. If a man have a stubborn and rebellious son, which will not obey the voice of his father or the voice of his mother, and that when they have chastened him, he will not hearken unto them, then shall his father and his mother lay hold on him, and bring him out unto the elders of the city, and unto the gates of the city. And they shall say unto the elders of the city, this our son is a stubborn and rebellious, he will not obey our voice, and he is a glutton and a drunkard. Verse 21, and all the men of the city shall stone him with stone, that he die, so that thou shalt put evil away from among you, and all Israel shall hear and fear. Isn't that sad? Well, you see, you can get to that point when you didn't train the child. You see, it's too late now. He wouldn't listen to you. He's a glutton. He's a drunkard. It's too late. You see, but based on the Bible, what he say, if you train him when he's young, he wouldn't depart. So you didn't train him. That's why he depart. So he wouldn't listen to father, he wouldn't listen to mother. Now you bring him to the city. Let him stone him with stone that he dies. So you put away evil. So a rebellious child is an evil child. That's what he said. A rebellious child is an evil child. Can you see that? You want to put away evil from among you. So you need to do something about that. Now we want to look at something here in Big John chapter 9. Big John chapter 9. Looking at our children and things that we should know.